Kicks on the gates. Todd Plain has the button. Parnham brings Zala in. They're ready to move. A small field. They're racing. Straight out the back to be last in the early stages. Black Wing. Jumping first is the favourite, Zala from Trademaster. They're going to head off Snow Bamboo. Return to Oz will posse up running fourth, but has to be heeled along in the early stages. Then Black Wing, who's down on the inside, dropping out last, is Love Strikes. Going over to the 1,300, into the back straight, the Tavistock mare leads the way, Zala. She's out by three quarters on Trademaster. A length and a half away at the 1,200, then Snow Bamboo. Return to Oz still being urged along on the outside to hold its posse up there, running fourth. Black Wing is next on the fence, and a length away last of all is Love Strikes. In this order, the field of six go past the 1,000. They're about to leave the back on the far corner, and it's Zala who makes play. Out by three quarters still, Trademaster. Snow Bamboo down on the inside, travelling in third posse, and a half a length away then on the outside, Return to Oz. He's still urging it along at this stage of the race, the Hyphenator. Johnston Porter hasn't stopped niggling from the time they got going on this well-backed commodity. A length and a half to Black Wing, who's over on the inside, and still back last of all is Love Strikes, the big blower in the betting. At the 500, they near the turn, and Zala's about to be tested by Trademaster, going up now and just testing this leader out. Zala by a neck, Trademaster now called upon, two clear from Snow Bamboo. To the outside, Johnston Porter, producer, the persuader on Return to Oz to come after them, and well back Love Strikes, Black Wing. Trademaster got about a half to three quarters on Zala, and looks to be in some bother. Trademaster's going better than it. Return to Oz going up and down on the one spot behind them. It's Trademaster with Zala trying to rally. Zala's coming back at Trademaster. Trademaster, Zala, they went to the line. There was nothing in it between them. Zala kicked again on the inside. Might have got it. Maybe Zala, who after getting clearly headed, could have got the bob. There's not much in it between it and Trademaster. And then behind those, Return to Oz, who just ground away there with Black Wing. Followed further back by Snow Bamboo. And Love Strikes ran right up to the betting drift and finished back there a distant last. Nothing in it between Zala, Trademaster. Trademaster got about a half to three quarters on Zala, but Zala came back. Trademaster's run came to an end in the shadows, and Zala has got the nose back down right on the post, and it looked as though may have just been able to get the margin, and it will. It'll get the result, Zala. Chris Parnham over Trademaster, and a long way back there in third placing. Return to Oz. Black Wing was behind those in company, in fact, with Love Strikes. He did beat one to the line, but pulled up really quickly after they'd gone past the post. 5-1-2-6 are the numbers. 5-1-2-6. Zala by Tavistock from Lady Peony, owned by Nevin Boddicker, trained by Simon Miller, ridden by Chris Parnham, takes out the maiden. Over Trademaster, the Trade Fair Rue de Marengo gelding, Teddy Martinovich, Jade McNaught, and Return to Oz, a Blackfriars Stormy Gale gelding, owned by Rene Durant, trained by Adam, and ridden by Clint Johnston Porter. 5-1-2-6. Margins, short half head, 2 3/4, 148.05. There is the time for the 1700 journey, 37.05, the last 600. So Zala getting it pretty cosy at the head of the field, stretched from 13 into a 1700. Trademaster levelled off with it, then probably kicked about a half at least in front. And Chris Parnham sat down there and really did lift this daughter of Tavistock to find. They had the others well and truly covered there, and she's got the money by a narrow margin, Zala, at her third career start. Passed in for quite an amount of money as a yearling in the sale ring, and she gets the job done in a maiden race today. Race two, the pre-fashion platform handicap over 1,400. And they're all going to run a field of eight. Let's head downstairs, and we'll join Brittany Taylor for the first time today on our service. Britt, a gritty win, had to fight back after being on the canvas, Zala, in the first.
Well, I would forgive you if you said that you thought that Trademaster was home and hose there, because I think most of us thought Trademaster was going past Zala, but to her credit and under the urgings of Chris Parnham, she was able to lift off the canvas. Simon, describe that last furlong to us as you saw it.
I thought it was a really good ride. He switched it up and threw the stick into the left and asked her to go again. She's still figuring out the game. Like, if she's in front, she needs a set of shades. And we may have gone a bit too slow, no fault of Chrissy's, but that's how we got rolled a pinch, and she's a better chaser, but the other day she was real flat-footed and wanted a trip. So it's a tricky one. I don't know whether... I'll go out in trip further because she wants it, but whether you shade her up or let her try and figure out the game, I don't know what the answer is.
How do you make that decision, and are you expecting that you may put them on for the next start?
I'll just see what Chris has to say. 50-50 if I get it right or wrong, isn't it? And if I get, I don't know yet. She's definitely looking for further. Like, she fought back there and ran through the lawn, but she just probably needs to go a bit quicker. But when you get those stain races, they generally walk, so maybe I might have to shade her up.
Now, there was a lot of talk, obviously, this morning on radio about your record. Typically a trainer of sprinters. Are you going to make a habit of these staying types?
I actually do enjoy training them, but, there's a lot of banter going around, wasn't there? Buddy Dean Lester started it, said I hadn't trained one since Black and White TV. And then Ali sent in the digs that my last staying winner was Senor Degama. So I was getting heat from everywhere.
Well, I guess you'll be the first person to the New Zealand sales to buy a stayer then.
No.
I didn't think so. Not your type.
Stayers are bred, not bought.
Well, this one is on the winning board for you today. Well done.
Thank you. It might be a really good horse.
Well, let's hope so. Simon Miller with the 1,700-metre winner in Zala, and Chris Parnham's catching up with Scott.
This one's class. It's bred, not bought as well. I've got Chris Parnham with me, Zala. Well, Chris, what did you make of last start's effort where she got beaten as an odds-on favourite?
Yeah, she was quite flat-footed that day. And, I think she's a horse that's just, it's a bit of a one-batter, so... in hindsight, I probably rode her a bit too cute that day, and today I sort of always rolled throughout, and then the second horse challenged me quite early, which surprised me, but it's good to kick back and win.
What do you think about distance-wise? Keep going out? Is that the way you'd be instructing Simon?
Yeah, I think she'd get 2,000, no problem, so especially at this stage of her preparation, she can probably head that way.
Congratulations, Chris. Well done.
Thank you.
Zala takes out the free entry to Belmont Park Maiden for Simon Miller and Chris Parnham. Something I can do for myself. Well, it's just a little thing, got a song to sing. Nobody don't care. Whistle what you think, you know. You better start collaboration, I swear. Give us something.